Hi everybody. You may not realize it, but June is Dairy Month, and for our final recipe this year for June Dairy Month, we are going to make a really delicious frozen treat, and it's a very kid-friendly recipe. They are strawberry cheesecake yogurt popsicles, and you're going to really like them. And what I especially like about this recipe is that it doesn't really require any specialized kitchen equipment. There are recipes out there where you need to use a food processor or a blender, but this particular one that we're going to do today, you just need a few basic kitchen essentials. So what you need to make your strawberry cheesecake yogurt popsicles, you need 1 cup of low-fat strawberry cheesecake yogurt. My favorite brand is Dan and Light and Fit. You need 8 ounces or 1 cup of diced strawberries, fresh, preferably. For me, that was 6 or 7 large strawberries. For you, it might be a little more or a little less, depending on how big your berries are. You need 1/2 cup of graham cracker crumbs. Now, for me, I used 3 graham crackers, and I actually put them in a Ziploc bag and made them into crumbs by using a rolling pin, okay? And then you need 1.5 tablespoons of butter. You're going to need 2 of mixing bowls, 2 of spatulas, a small paring knife and a cutting board, and we'll get to that in a minute. And then you need something to put your popsicles in while they freeze. So if you have popsicle molds, those work great. You can also use ice cube trays, or you can do what I'm doing, and I'm just using small paper cups. And then of course, you need a popsicle stick to go in each one. Or you can also use straws. So some people take straws and cut them in half. So that's what you need to get started with this recipe. And of course, as with any time you're doing food preparation, you want to be sure you wash your hands and that they're nice and clean. And so we are going to start out by dicing our strawberries. So I've already done most of mine. And of course, if you are younger and you're not used to handling a knife, you may want some adult assistance or supervision with this part. But just take your time and be very careful. I just use a small paring knife for this. And so you're going to just take your berries and you're going to cut that top off where the stem is. And then I just like to cut mine in half lengthwise. And then I cut them into quarters, so I take each one of those and I cut it again. And then for this recipe, since I want pretty small pieces in my pops, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut each of those pieces in half. And then I'm going to dice them. So I'm just going to cut really small pieces of each one of those. Like I said, if you're not used to handling a knife, be sure that you have some adult assistance with this part. And just take your time. Nobody likes to have a diced finger. Now, if you are someone that doesn't like chunks of fruit in your ice cream or your yogurt, you may want to use a blender to blend up the pieces of the strawberry even smaller. I like bits of fruit in mine, and so I'm just going to use this hand dicing. And now we're going to add these berries to our measuring cup. And it just so happens the yogurt that I'm using today is exactly 1 cup in each one of these small individual containers. So I'm just going to take that lid off and I'm going to take my spatula and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put that yogurt into my mixing bowl. Now you can use whatever fruit you would like. If you don't like strawberries, you can use a different kind of fruit. whatever fruit you use, you might want to try to find the corresponding yogurt to go with it. So for example, if you want to do blueberry instead, use blueberries and blueberry yogurt. Then go ahead and take your diced strawberries and put them in the mixing bowl with your yogurt. You're going to mix it up really good. You want to be sure that you have lots of berries in each yogurt pop. See how that looks? Perfect. All right, so now here's where the fun part comes in. In your other mixing bowl, we're going to take your graham cracker crumbs, and then we're going to take your melted butter, and we're going to combine those. Just going to pour that butter over the top. If you've ever made a graham cracker crust for anything, this is kind of how you make it. You make it with butter and graham cracker crumbs. You're just going to mix the butter in with those graham cracker crumbs. All right. So now we're ready to start putting our yogurt into our cups. And I'm going to start with 4. This recipe size will make 4 to 6 of this size, depending on the size of your container. If you have popsicle molds, or you have a different size cup, or you use ice cube trays, it may make a few more or a few less. So you'll just have to experiment with that the first time that you try it. And so now you're just going to spoon into each cup our yogurt and strawberry mix. Already looks delicious. I can't wait. These make a really good treat if you've been out and it's hot and you want something to cool off, or maybe you just want something sweet after dinner, or maybe you want a mid-afternoon snack. You've been out busy and or you just got home from school, or you've been at a ball game or swimming. These make a really awesome treat. And you can use a spoon for this as well. You don't have to use the spatula. Sometimes getting that last little bit of strawberry is kind of difficult. All right, so I have my 4 here, and I'm just going to level them out a little bit, just kind of shake them a little bit. And then I'm going to take a little bit of my graham cracker, and I'm going to put it on the top of each one. Now you can make it thin, so your graham crackers go a little further. Or you can make it thick if that's how you like it. It really just gives it a little bit of an extra crunch. All right. And so now we're ready to add our popsicle sticks. And there we have it. So what happens now? Take these, pop them in the freezer. Might take about 3 hours or so for them to be good and frozen. But then anytime you want a cool, delicious dairy treat, you just go to the freezer and you take out one of your strawberry cheesecake yogurt pops. Now you might need to run just a little bit of warm water over your paper cup to get it out. Don't run too much or you'll melt your pop before you get to eat it. But that usually helps loosen it so you can get it right out of that paper cup. And that's all there is to it. I hope you really enjoy this wonderful, delicious dairy treat.